Forbes issued a scathing warning to companies all over the United States this past weekend, telling them that if you hire any of these former Trump cabinet officials, we're just going to assume from that point forward that everything that comes out of your company is an absolute lie. Now, we all know Forbes is the paper of repute, the magazine of repute for the Fortune 500 crowd, right? I mean, after all, that's the Forbes Fortune 500. They're the ones who do that. They're the ones who you want to suck up to if you are a corporation. You want to make it on their list. You want to make it to their parties. You want to be their friends. And here they are telling the most powerful corporations in the United States, if you go anywhere near these people, we're done with you. Here is actually what was said in the article that they posted. Forbes will assume that everything your company or firm talks about is a lie. We're going to scrutinize, double check, investigate with the same skepticism we'd approach a Trump tweet if you hire these individuals. And that includes people like Betsy DeVos, Elaine Chao, Mick Mulvaney, Stephanie Grisham, Sarah Matthews, Matthew Pottinger, and of course the usual suspects of Kayleigh McEnany, Kellyanne Conway, hell, Sarah Huckabee Sanders, Sean Spicer, if he's still kicking around out there. Basically, if you spent time working with Donald Trump, Forbes is telling their connections in the business community, don't hire these people. Now, I have no sympathy for any of these people. I don't care if they don't ever work another day in their lives. There's another group of people, though, inside the White House who are also struggling to find work for essentially the same reason. Those are the average everyday White House staffers. According to reports over the last few weeks, these staffers have been unable to secure jobs. A lot of them have been unable to secure interviews at other places. Like, nobody wants to hire anyone who worked for the Trump administration, whether you were a cabinet official, you know, sitting at the head of a major government department, or if you're just the coffee boy. It doesn't matter. You worked for Trump. You have that stink on you. You have the taint on you. You are stained with Trumpism. And now, a week ago, that wasn't as bad as it is today. It was still pretty bad. They were still struggling to find work. But after what happened on Wednesday, suddenly, all these brands, all these companies, all these entities out there hiring people are aware of the fact that you were part of the guy that started this. You were part of the guy that encouraged this. You're toxic. You're dangerous. We can't have you on our staff. For the average everyday White House staffers, I do feel a little bit, very little bit of sympathy for them. I mean, we've been warning them for 4 years this would happen. So that's why it's not more sympathy. Like, everybody saw this coming. You know, you're staring down the tunnel and the train's coming at you and you're like, huh, hope I don't get hit by that thing. Ah, I think I'm gonna get hit by it. Pow. Yeah, we told you you'd get hit by the train. And so, yes, it's sad you got hit by a train, but at the same time, you could have moved off the track at any time.